to another episode of Past Millie's Point. And as always, do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss a video. Let's get to the point. So, today on this video, we're going to talk about my top five movies of all time. And that's right, my top five movies of all time. Nobody else's. This isn't based on Academy Awards, anything like that. This is all about me and the movies that I like. And to the way that I based this list was kind of how many repeat viewings have I had of these movies and why I like them so much. So, without further ado, let's get started with number one. Number one to me is Pulp Fiction.
What?
Pulp Fiction.
What?
Pulp Fiction. Anyways, so the reason I love the movie so much is the story. The story is just so amazing. There's so many things going on in the story. You got a person overdosing, a briefcase that's trying to be stolen, someone's head gets blown off.
What the fuck's happening now?
Oh, man.
Oh man, I shot Marvin in the face.
Why the fuck did you do that?
Someone gets kidnapped by a gimp. I mean, there's all kind of crazy stuff going on. But what makes it great is the cast. There's a great cast. Uma Thurman, Bruce Willis, John Travolta, Samuel Jackson, Ving Rhames, Quentin Tarantino makes an appearance, Harvey Keitel. There is all kind of people in this movie. And it's just so great how the story is broken up into different sections, but it all kind of ties into itself. And there's some great scenes. I mean, you got the scene in the apartment where they go to steal the briefcase from these guys.
What does Marcellus Wallace look like?
What?
What country are you from?
What?
What ain't no country I ever heard of? They speak English and what?
What?
English, motherfucker! Do you speak it?
Yes!
Then you know what I'm saying.
Yes.
Describe what Marcellus Wallace looks like.
But the best scene is in the diner with the wallet, the bad motherfucker wallet. That is the best scene.
And find my wallet.
Which one is it?
It's the one that says bad motherfucker.
And both of those scenes have Samuel Jackson in them, and I'm just a big fan of his as well. Almost anything he's in, I really do enjoy. So that's my number one. Number two for me is going to be Back to the Future. And Back to the Future, right out of the gate, the way it starts, you know this movie is going to have a great soundtrack, which it does. It has a great soundtrack. And the soundtrack is basically mostly Huey Lewis and the News. But I mean, geez, the soundtrack's really good. But you also got a great cast. You got Michael J. Fox. You got Christopher Lloyd. You got Crispin Glover. Leah Thompson, I believe. But my favorite person in the whole movie is Biff Tannen. Biff Tannen is such a great character.
Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Hey, think.
Why? Because you hate him. You literally hate this guy for being such a jerk all the time for no reason. It doesn't make any sense why he's a jerk to McFly. He just is. And that's just the kind of person he is. And I think that the whole entire story is good. It's very heartwarming. It's definitely a family film that you could watch with your family, I feel like. There might be a couple parts that are a little risque, but for the most part, it's very family-oriented, family fun. I think there's a lot of cool nods, like how they play the time travel game, kind of. I really like that. And there's, you know, I love the part where he plays Johnny B. Goode at the Under the Sea dance. I think that's a great scene.
And try and keep up, okay?
Also, the scene where he's on the skateboard riding around is pretty cool. And Michael J. Fox is just such, he just seems like such a cool person, just such a cool guy. I mean, I don't know if that's how Michael J. Fox is in real life, but as Marty McFly, I want to be friends with Marty McFly. He knows a doctor that can do time travel. Come on, man.
1.21 gigawatts! 1.21 gigawatts!
My number three movie, and spoiler alert, no, I'm just kidding. If you didn't, my number three movie, And if you didn't see this coming, then I feel bad for you. It's going to be Captain America, Winter Soldier. Now, if you watch my top five MCU movies, this was my number one movie. And number one, it's
today, Junior?
My favorite Marvel movie because of Chris Evans. Chris Evans as Captain America, I think, is such a great choice to play Captain America. He seems like he is that all-American hero that people really need. He's just, I don't know, he's awesome. And there's a lot of good action scenes in the movie. There's the scene on the bridge, there's the scene in the elevator, which is like one of my favorite scenes in any action movie.
Before we get started, does anyone want to get out?
And just the story in general of how somebody can infiltrate the government without the actual head of like the government knowing, and how they make Captain America out to be the bad guy, even though he's the one trying to stop them from overtaking everything. And Winter Soldier as a villain, he's just so great in it. But not only is he a villain, he's tied to Captain America, which makes it so great on why he really wants to stop the Winter Soldier. And it also moves Cap's story along. You learn a little bit more. Plus, they introduce Anthony Mackie as the Falcon, which I really liked a lot, and I thought he was great. And I think he's a great superhero, but I also think he's also very funny, which you don't get a lot with the superhero guys.
I'm impressed, Mr. Stark. So, I'm really sorry.
What?
You couldn't have done that earlier.
I hate you.
Maybe Ant-Man because of Paul Rudd, but I think he's very great in a superhero capacity, and I really enjoy him in this movie as well. Even though he's not in it a whole lot, I really do like the scenes that he is in. My number four movie is Die Hard, and it is a Christmas movie.
Die Hard is not a Christmas movie!
I don't care what Bruce Willis said. It's a Christmas movie. I watch it every Christmas Eve. It's a Christmas movie. The number one thing about this movie for me is the hero versus villain. Hans Gruber versus John McClane. And the way that they play off of each other, and they don't see each other basically for almost, I would say, 70% of the movie before they actually see each other. That's kind of crazy if you ask me, because they're not face to face. You don't see that interaction with each other. It's basically all through radio, but how much they try and play games with each other. And Bruce Willis is actually really, really funny in this movie, even though it's supposed to be an action movie. I think he made his own kind of brand in that movie, which I think is great for him, because it brought, you know, some more like comedy action guys, because at that time you're big and macho and muscular guys, those are the action stars, you know, your Dolph Lundgrens and Sylvester Stallones and Arnold Schwarzeneggers and stuff like that. But here you got just a regular guy, John McClane, just a cop who's doesn't play by the rules.
Do you really think you have a chance against us, Mr. Cowboy?
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
And that's another reason I liked it so much. It's just kind of like it's him against everybody in the building, and he outsmarts everybody. Not because he's smarter than everybody, but because he has the heart and the soul to not let anybody get hurt, because that's what a good cop does. I also like Reginald, I think it's Reginald Vell Johnson in the movie. He plays Al.
Hey, Roy, how you feeling?
Pretty fucking unappreciated, Al.
Hey, look, I love you. So do a lot of the other guys. So you hang in there, man. You hear me?
I think he was great in the movie. He was, he's like the saving grace for John McClane on the outside, and he's trying to get him to help him on the inside, which I thought the way those two characters played off each other was very well. There's a lot of good chemistry, I feel like, in this movie. And then my final pick, my number five pick, is Jurassic Park. Why? Because there's fucking dinosaurs in the movie. Who doesn't like a dinosaur? That shit is crazy. And they take over. They basically escape and take over and do everything that they want to do. Kill, eat each other, fight, whatever it is. The T-Rex in the movie, super cool. The best part of the movie is the raptors, except for this guy.
Clever girl.
He probably didn't think they were too cool. But I like the concept of them getting out and kind of taking over the island that they're on. I also enjoyed that, like, it's these kids and these two doctors, or not doctors, but they're like, I don't know, paleontologists or whatever they're called that study dinosaurs. And they are basically trying to figure out how to get out of there. And Jeff Goldblum's in it. He's great. Samuel Jackson is in it in a small capacity, but he's also good. But Wayne Knight or...
Oh, Newman.
He's good as like the villain, the guy who's trying to escape with these little like dinosaur eggs and try and get them back to somebody who's going to pay a bunch of money. So basically he's going to, you know, let these dinosaurs loose and try and get out of the island, but he ends up getting his. So it's just, again, it's like a nice little like survival movie on how they're going to stay alive. And I think that it's a little scary, it's a little thrillery, it's got a little action, and it's funny. Plus, who can resist the Jeff Goldblum charm?
God creates dinosaurs, God destroys dinosaurs, God creates man, man destroys God, man creates dinosaurs.
I think it's an amazing movie. I love it. And again, that's another movie. I've probably seen that movie 20 times. Every time that movie's on, I'm sitting down to watch it. But that's my top five list. Please drop a comment down there. What's your top five? Maybe there's a movie I haven't seen in there and I should check out. Maybe I totally disagree with your top five. Who knows? But I won't know unless you drop them down below. But folks, that's it for the video. But I'll see you guys again next week. Thanks.